प्राउड आईआईटीएन,
प्राउड आईआईटीएन,
प्राउड आईआईटीएन,
प्राउड आईआईटीएन।
सो वेलकम टू साक्षी ऑन द शो। साक्षी, कांग्रेचुलेशंस फॉर गेटिंग इनटू द आईआईटीएन। या सो साक्षी, व्हाट डू यू थिंक सेपरेट्स यू फ्रॉम द रेस्ट ऑफ द क्राउड, बिकॉज यू आर वन ऑफ द वेरी फ्यू स्टूडेंट्स हु हैज गॉट इनटू द आईआईटीएन, and what is it that differentiates you or makes you stand apart from the crowd?
I don't think I have any special quality, but one of the materialistic reason I think that is mobile phones, because 90% students uses it in 11th.
Right.
Even school students are using it. But I have preferred not to use it, because where mobile comes, distraction is obvious. So that I think, and sir have also told me that I have never given attitude. I think that might be one of the differentiating factor.
Wow, good, good. So she was one of the girls who was always scoring good marks but never showed it in her attitude or on her face, and at the same time she has stayed away from the digital world for 2 to 3 years. That's amazing. Now, Sakshi, was it a case that some of your subjects were weak in the beginning and then you had to put in a lot of effort and make it better at the end? So, how did you overcome your weak subjects?
First of all, my weak subject is physics.
Okay.
I used to hate that subject like anything. But when sir make me understood that not whole physics is difficult for me, just choose out some subtopics that might be cope up with. So I started to find that, and at the starting I used to first solve as many as solved examples I can. So my basic concept would get clear, I would get the strategies. Then I used to jump on the level 1 exercise, and if I'm comfortable with level 1, I think that yes, I'm getting that sums. Then I used to go on level 2. Otherwise some topic is difficult for me, I used to focus only on the basic concept, not on the advanced level sums. So I used to think it as the subtopic wise. If any subtopic is good for me, I can cope up with that greatly, then I used to do that whole level 1, level 2. But SWOT example helped me a lot.
Okay.
Weak subjects.
Okay. So Sakshi is saying that always go step by step, because you cannot directly jump to the advanced exercises in your books. First you have to clear your concepts and fundamentals and then go step by step. Look at how you're progressing rather than comparing yourself with the others who are already solving advanced exercises. So that's a very good advice, Sakshi. Another thing that I want to really ask you is, again, being a woman, how does it feel to get into the IITs? Because even today if we see, the percentage of girls getting into the IITs is lesser than boys. So what is your thought on it?
Firstly, it doesn't matter for me that boys and girls ratio is very high or what. But at the starting, when I entered the JEE path, then my schoolmates who were entering JEE, most of them were boys. And I was the only girl who were entering from our group, our friends group. And my friends were for NEET and all that. That stereotypes are there, like NEET is for girls and JEE is for boys. That matters only for the starting years. As study started, lectures and all, we get into that and it doesn't matter at all. And if I think I am successful in this exam, then that stereotype also breaks.
Yes, absolutely.
After that, branches came. So, same with the branches, there are stereotypes like mechanical is for boys, chem is for girls.
Yes.
That also, it doesn't matter, because we know that they were saying that JEE were for the boys. But
it's wrong. And she's saying that if you want to pursue something that is dominated by men, then do it without thinking about it. So as a transformation example, right, from the first mock test to the final exam, what was the transformation that you showed?
When I entered this institute of this academy, I used to be 8th and 9th in my class. So my chasing thought, many people take comparison in a negative way, but it works me positively, So comparison makes me to push harder as much as I can. So I used to be 8th and 9th, but I used to think, 7th and 9th, why I can't defeat them, I can't like that, I used to study and I used to focus. For last exam, IIT, which IIT should I get, which branch would I get, I was not thinking that. Only tuition papers, test, mock test. I used to see ki mere aage kaun hai and I want to defend them.
Mm-hmm.
Slowly I get to the rank 4, then I used to think ki how could I beat rank 3, then after 3rd, then 2nd. That chasing thought gives me push on the rank.
Yeah, so that is a very good thought, because she says that competition is something that gives her energy, and when she sees that she's left behind, she is the one who wants to be at the top, and that is why she puts in effort in that direction. Very nice, Sakshi. It was great talking to you. And one last question. Would you like to give some tip to our viewers, whoever is appearing for IIT or any other exam in the world, and how do they conquer that exam?
I think consistency is one of the main factors. I mean,
very true.
Consistency is very important, and I would suggest that for your weak subject, when it comes to your weak subject, just start it from the basic level, don't, and work smartly in your weak subjects.
Mm-hmm.
I think, for example, my
physics.
Yes. So some derivations are there. Derivation, we don't need to remember them, but obviously teachers gives us the derivation explanation from where this result have came. Some derivations were out of my mind. I used to not get them, but I worked smartly and I just skipped the derivation and remembered the result, which I will be needing in exam, not the derivation. So work smartly in your weak subjects.
Very nice. Very nice. It's not always the hard work that matters. It's a combination of smart thinking and hard work that brings you success. Thanks a lot, Sakshi, once again for your time. Welcome to Sanket on the show, who is our fourth candidate. Congratulations, Sanket. Now, I want to ask you, what are the advantages and disadvantages of studying in a small town? Because you also come from Shahpur and you've never gone out in a nearby city like Mumbai. You have stayed for 2 years right here in Shahpur and you have cracked IIT. So, what are the advantages and disadvantages of studying here?
So, disadvantages first. तो मैं यहाँ पे ही रहता था, 10th तक मैंने यहाँ पे स्टडी की, तो मेरे काफी दोस्त मुझे खेलते हुए दिखते थे, लेकिन मुझे वो बहुत अवॉइड करना पड़ता था ताकि मुझे JEE के एग्जाम को क्रैक करना। मोरेवर यहाँ पे आपको वो स्टडी एनवायरमेंट नहीं मिलता, मतलब हमारे यहाँ पे स्पेसिफिक बैच हुआ करते थे तो हम वहाँ पे काफी अच्छी पढ़ाई करते थे, बट वंस यू आर आउट ऑफ दिस बबल यू वोंट फाइंड एनीथिंग स्टडी। तो मुझे वो पार करने के लिए बहुत मेहनत करनी पड़ी। एडवांटेजेस, सर बहुत ज्यादा हेल्पफुल थे, तो वो मुझे सारी मतलब डिफिकल्टीज जो आती थी वो अच्छे से क्लियर करने में बहुत ज्यादा मदद करते।
नाइस। सो व्हाट आर द स्पेसिफिक बुक्स और रिसोर्सेज दैट यू स्टडीड फ्रॉम, बिकॉज सपोज सम ऑफ आवर व्यूअर्स आर द वंस हु आर अपीयरिंग फॉर IIT, सो व्हिच रिसोर्सेज वुड यू रेकमेंड देम?
सो फॉर मी सर, आई हैव गिवन अ रेजोनेंस मॉड्यूल, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल सॉल्व ऑल द मॉड्यूल्स दैट यू हैव गिवन टू सर, देन स्पेसिफिक बुक्स like sir have given particular books for particular subjects, so we have solved all the books that sir have given. Tests are very important, try to give weekly tests, analyze them, look where you have done the mistakes, so that is the key, you know.
Yes, analysis is very important, because you just can't keep giving the mock tests, you have to see where you've gone wrong and correct it. Very nice, Sanket. One tip, Sanket, that you want to give the aspiring candidates of any entrance exam in the world or in India, be it IIT or any other entrance exam?
See, for me, consistency is very important. It doesn't matter how much hours you put in a single day. It matters most how many days you put in. So, ये ढाई साल बहुत लंबा प्रोसेस होता है. तो आपको every day you have to get up, do the study. That is very important for the long.
Yes, it's a grind that we all have to go through, and as Sakshi had mentioned, Sanket is again emphasizing on the same point of consistency. You have to do the same thing again and again and again and reach where you want to. Very nice, Sanket. Any other things that you want to share with our aspiring candidates?
Don't lose hope. Initially, I used to score very less in the exams as well. But I used to do more and more hard work. So you will definitely get success. It doesn't matter if you get in JEE, but in life you will definitely.
Yes, so he's not just saying that this is limited to IIT JEE. He is saying that never lose hope, even if you're not performing well, that's okay. If you just keep on going on your path of dreams, you will get there. Very nice, Sanket. Thanks a lot for sharing your thoughts with us.
Thank you.
Sanket, I also want to ask you, how does the preparation for IIT help in preparing for CET? Because there are a lot of candidates who are preparing for CET currently, and how do you think it helps the preparation for IIT?
So IIT का preparation एक level ऊपर रखना ही होता है, तो आपको concepts वो बार मतलब फिर से करने की कोई जरूरत नहीं होती. जस्ट आपको बहुत सारे क्वेश्चन पेपर सॉल्व करने पड़ेंगे, मॉक टेस्ट देने पड़ेंगे. ये स्पीड का गेम होता है, तो 3 घंटे में आपको 150 क्वेश्चन सॉल्व करने होते, तो आपको बहुत ज्यादा स्पीड लाना पड़ता है. कंसेप्ट और वो चीज हो ही जाती है. तो JEE अगर आपने अच्छा किया तो आपका 150 तक स्कोर वैसे ही आ जाता है. जस्ट आगे का जो 50 का स्कोर होता है वो स्पीड से ही आता है. तो आप स्पीड अगर ला लो आपकी सॉल्व करने में, तो आप कर सकते हो.
Okay, nice, 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 good. So he is saying that prepare for IIT, aim for the higher, even for the moon. Even if you do not reach there, you will land among the stars. So that is what he is saying. Thank you.